give us those why me moments so we can look and depend on him.
I'm so glad. That was great. That's a great way to start this segue out. I am so glad. Oh man, God be the glory. So as we heard the story and we look at the first one, everybody in him. That's another thing too. Let us just be brief. I don't care who you is. I don't care how saved. I don't care how full of the Holy Ghost you is. I don't care how long you've been saved. I don't care how much faith you got. Everybody in here don't have them why me moments.
Amen.
Why me? First thing we got to understand and realize, why me? Why me? When we start going through, I don't know about y'all, but it's a situation that goes on in our life, and I don't care. You can pray, and it seems like that thing won't move. And you keep asking the Lord, why me? And we're going to figure out why you. Watch this. And really, tell the truth, we can go ahead and go home out there. What been bad that got you talking about?
Amen.
But we got to be encouraged. And guess what, y'all? The Bible said that the strong have to bear the infirmity of the weak. Y'all know what that means. See, you may be up right now. Everything going good. Got a good banking account. Everything going your way. You just getting up drinking coffee and you ain't got no bill collecting nothing. Your body doing pretty good. Doctor told you that you making it all right. So when you in that moment right now, guess what you need to do? You need to find somebody that's a little lower than you is. That's going through a little something, and you go encourage them. Amen. Because guess what? Your name.
Amen.
That's why you got to be careful if you know somebody in the hospital and you saying, I'm hoping they all right. No! You need to poke your head in. Listen, is you okay? What can I do for you? Why? Because one day. Okay. Y'all know that old song, though.
There's a leak in this old building. And my soul, what that leak is?
That means this whole body cutting up.
Amen.
Hold up. That means when you go to the doctor and he say, I don't know, your blood pressure that keeps shooting up. I can't, we got to figure out something. What's going on?
There's a leak in this old building.
And one day, your day gonna come.
Amen.
That's why, y'all, it's very important that we encourage those along the way. Like she said, your storm may not be my storm. Your problem may not be my problem, but it's a problem. So when we on the upside of our situation, what we need to do, find somebody to encourage. Don't step back and look down. I hope they're doing all right. Now, come on, I got my situation together. Now they need to go ahead and get there together. Don't do that. We must, because we don't know who going through what. Sometimes God will place people in your spirit, and you need to go ahead and pray for them. Every night, let me tell y'all something, this ain't no lie. Every night, one of y'all pop in my spirit. One of y'all. It'd be folks I don't even know that they come on first or third Sunday. They just pop up. I just can't just shake that off and say, I don't know what's going on, son. Let me get to sleep, man. I can't keep worrying about that. I got to bring that. Lord, whatever it is, protect me. Lord, touch them. Lord, do this. Lord, whatever going on with them right now, Lord. And then I might get called the next morning. Out of the blue. How you doing? You doing all right? All right, then. They want to hear your ball. So-and-so. Why? They may need encouragement. There's a lot of discouraged folks in the church, y'all.
Amen.
There's a lot of folk that look like this on Sunday.